Good morning, everyone. Thank you for starting the day out with me. I'm Jenna Stauffer. According to the National Institute of Mental Health, anxiety disorders are the most common mental illness in the U.S. It affects 40 million adults, or 18.1% of the U.S. population. That number, it's just too large. Now, my first guest this morning, she's a board-certified physician. She's been practicing medicine for the past 20 years. She's also an author. She's recently released the book Anxiety 101, and in this, she explores anxiety disorder, also gives us ways to treat and manage the symptoms. She'll share some of her research with us this morning. Dr. Harry, thank you so much for being here with me
today.
Thank
you for having me. It's my pleasure to be here today.
Well, it's a pleasure having you here, and you are based in Orlando, and as I mentioned, you have over 20 years of experience in medicine. Tell us a little more about your background.
Well, I am based in Orlando currently, and I'm the medical director of Oasis for Optimal Health, and I started that practice because I saw a lot of chronic illnesses that I thought people really needed to be educated about. So I am board certified in emergency medicine and board certified in holistic medicine. So I think the combination gives me a little bit more information on how to approach this in a well-rounded way.
Now, Dr. Harry, I mentioned some of the statistics of anxiety and the numbers for people who suffer from anxiety disorders. It's so large. Why do you believe that so many people suffer from this?
Well, and the number is continuing to increase is what we are noticing. And I think many people are suffering from this. One is certainly, we know the economy has been very stressful for everyone, but even prior to that, the numbers were increasing. And I think it has to do something with the expectations we have on ourselves. And when we're not able to meet those expectations, then anxiety is then generated from that. It's also been shown that anxious parents, if a child lives in an anxiety environment, then a child is more prone to anxiety. So we may be creating some of this as we go along as well. And not to mention, of course, we have a lot of a lot of media available to us. We're always trying to keep up on everything. We're constantly trying to multitask all the time. And all of that is anxiety provoking.
Now, when would you say it's time for someone to get help for their anxiety?
If your anxiety is starting to affect your quality of life, if you're now becoming afraid to go out of your house in the morning, if you notice your productivity is going down, if you're becoming more and more irritable, if you're really jumpy every time the phone rings because you're expecting bad news all the time, you're perhaps even afraid to go out to your mailbox to check the mail because you're so anxious that there's going to be something distressful in that. It's time to really seek help. It's now affecting not only your quality of life, but your family's quality of life as well.
So if people out there are experiencing those symptoms, you say that it's time for them then to go to a physician, or who should they talk with about it?
That's a very good question, because what the statistics are telling us that many people do not seek out the help of a psychiatrist, for example. They will go to their family physicians, but not for anxiety, but for the symptoms that are generated from anxiety. So many people would go with palpitations, with insomnia, with shakiness, and they go with, then they're very convinced that there is something I like to call like physically wrong with them, or they do have an illness, and the physician will go through the testing that he needs to go through to make sure they don't have any cardiac disease, hypoglycemia, etc. And then he may discover that what they're really suffering from is anxiety. We know that the majority of physician visits are secondary to anxiety type symptoms.
Okay, so you do suggest then going to a psychologist before the physician?
I suggest you should go to the physician to sort out, to make sure you do not have any physiological issues going on. Many times patients are aware that they are anxious and are aware that they're overly stressed, but many times they really don't feel comfortable saying that. Mm-hmm. If they do have perhaps a church outlet that they can go to start talking to someone about it, that's a good place to go as well. If you're feeling the physical symptoms of anxiety and that there are many things that can also give you those symptoms, you do of course want to be sure that you don't have a physical illness. But when you discover that it is indeed anxiety, that I think is when you need to consider different steps besides perhaps just taking something to initially dull the anxiety, you might want to look at a holistic approach at that point to putting your life back together.
Wonderful. And we're going to take a quick break right now, but we're going to focus on your holistic approach that you have to really managing anxiety. We'll be right back after these messages, so stay with us. There's much more to come this morning.